The fungible goods and materials came from General Note 12 of the Harmonized Tariff Schedule of the United States. And let me see if I can pull it up. Yes, I can. So we're on General Note 12. Let's see. So let me make it a little larger. All right, so fungible goods and materials. This is a topic that has been tested on exam. And it's not really that different from the other definitions which we meet across the scope of the Harmonized Tariff Schedule, the Code of Federal Regulations. For example, in classification portion, we have a whole section dedicated to fungible goods and materials. We have fungible goods and materials definition in various other free trade agreements, and they're essentially the same thing. And the goal for the concept of fungible good and material is to really make it easier for the administration or for the customs officials, administration of the customs business, as well as for the manufacturers and importers to comply with the provisions of whatever agreement it is in. In this case, it deals with the accounting methodology. So, in other words, instead of coming forward with the evidence for that particular product, you can just come in with a method with generally accepted accounting principles methodology, the warehouse or inventory management methodology, and just show the process while sticking, of course, to the process, and that will meet your burden of coming forward with the evidence and showing that you are complying with the provisions of the particular trade agreement. So in this case, just like with many other free trade agreements and sections of the HTSUS, fungible means exchangeable, means it's tradable. It has identical purposes. It can be substituted very easily. And the reason why you have that, and this is also defined in 19 CFR 102, section 1021, you also have those are the reasons. And one of them is you do not need to directly identify any particular product, and you can use it on the basis of approved inventory management system. So the first question that comes up with respect to the fungibility of a product is the following. The customs pretty much is asking you for the definition of the fungible clause itself. Here's what they say. For customs country of origin purposes, fungible goods or fungible material means, and we have here the correct answer, goods that are essentially interchangeable for commercial purposes with those properties that are essentially identical to others. So we have those buzzwords, essentially identical, interchangeable, essentially identical, and that is the correct answer choice. Looking at the other choices throughout the question, we can see that usable goods and materials which have been produced in a single country, it can be, but the problem is you have to have those identical and interchangeable characteristics. Commercial goods that have been assembled and advanced in value, well, the problem is that there is no those buzzwords here. Again, they can be assembled and advanced in value, but the problem is they have to have this identical thing. Waste, scrap, imported for recovery. Again, nothing about identical or exchangeable. And perishable materials for US consumption, again, buzzwords are missing. So the key here is to recognize the buzzwords, interchangeable, identical, means fungible, and the goal of this is for the inventory management control. So if you learn that, you will not only be fine with NAFTA, you will also be fine with a lot of other questions that come from the customs broker exam related to other trade agreements, related to the even to the evaluation, because we see that concept in evaluation, as well as classification.